Behind every great meal, there is a story. And behind every great recipe, there is a journey. Behind the Recipe.
When I was a little kid, I loved to cook. When you're a kid, it's like fantastic. You get to sift things and there's eggs that you get to break and whip up. It's like a little construction kit. And at the end of it, there's cookies. I grew up in a town called Northfield, Vermont. There isn't a lot of Mexican food there. When I was a kid, my mom used to tell us how when she and my father were in Texas, they used to stop at roadside stands and buy tamales by the dozen. And I was under the impression that a tamale was a fruit. That's what I thought pretty much until I got to Seattle. When I moved to Seattle, I was working at a little Italian restaurant, and most of the staff are from Mexico, 6'2", and I am not. I am a little guy. And so Pablo is the Spanish version for Paul. If you add Ito to the end, it's like something that's cute and little. And so Pablito was their name for me. And they would bring in food that their moms had made or that they had made at home. And it was the first time that I'd ever had real Mexican food. I was drawn to it. I loved it. The tortillas and the tamales, things like gorditas and sopes that I didn't even know what they were. The tortilla is to Mexicans what bread is to the French and rice is to the Japanese. It is the basis for food. Tortillas were a constant thing in my house growing up, just the store-bought flour tortillas. As I got older, I got more interested in making things by hand. I convinced a friend of mine, Luis, to show me how to make tortillas the real way, the traditional Mexican way. He brought me to his house and got out the masa and the flour, and we made it by hand. And we didn't use a press even. We just patted them out with our hands, cooked them on the tamal, and they were amazing and delicious. Ever since Luis taught me how to make tortillas, I love making them. And every day, I get a little excited about making them. I keep trying new little variations. I keep trying different flours. I keep trying like a little less salt, a little more salt, a little more water, a little less water. And it keeps coming back to the original one, Mexican food. It's casual and it's a little bit messy. You just pick it up and you eat it. And you can talk and you share it with people. Eating should be something you share. And the more people you share it with, the better. That's just heaven for me. That's just what it's all about.